The story of the seed and the farmer. At the time of harvest, there is an atmosphere of joy and glee in the village. A farmer works really hard from sowing of seed till harvesting the crop. Ram and Shyam are brothers. Their father is a farmer. In this video, let us know the story of a seed and the farmer through two brothers, Ram and Shyam. Learning objective: to understand the journey of a seed from the farm till the kitchen of a house.
Brother, I'm very hungry.
We are about to reach home. Mom must be cooking hot chapatis.
Ma, we are hungry.
Wash your hands and come into the kitchen.
Bajra and wheat grains are kept in the kitchen. Ram notices them.
What are these, Ma?
Let me tell you about the grains from which you get energy to study and play.
Shyam looks at grains surprisingly.
Ma, you give us chapati and vegetable to eat.
The chapatis you are eating are made of these grains.
But these are big seeds and they are not there in the chapati.
Because I churned these seeds in the grindstone to make flour and then prepare dough to make chapatis. Quickly finish your food and then I will tell you the story of a seed. How it is produced and how farmer protects it from pests and takes it to everyone's house.
Both the children quickly finish their food.
Let me take you to your father's farm where these seeds are produced.
After reaching the farm, both the children inquisitively ask their father about the seeds.
Tell us about the seed crops. How do you grow them? Protect them from pests and everything else about crops?
Children, the chapatis which your mother cooked today were made of bajra. Bajra is a kind of cereal which is grown in the states of Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Gujarat, etc. in India. Like bajra, finger millet, sorghum, jowar, etc. are other cereals which are used to prepare different healthy food like porridge, poha, parathas, etc. The funniest thing is, less water is required to grow bajra crop. That is why it can be grown in desert areas of Rajasthan and Gujarat and hence also called drought-resistant crop.
We were not knowing that there are grains which need less water to grow.
Father, give us elaborate information about farmer and seed.
Son, a farmer starts celebrating when he starts plowing the field.
What is plowing?
A farmer uses plow or tractor to prepare the soil for sowing seeds by digging and overturning it.
Does he add seeds after this process?
Yes, children. He sows the seeds and then timely and as per the requirement of crops, irrigates the field.
What is the meaning of irrigation?
The process of supplying water to the field by artificial means, canal, tube well, etc. to increase the quantity of water present in the soil is called irrigation.
Father, people would be very happy when crops of these seeds get ready.
Yes, people celebrate different harvest festivals in different states when crops are harvested.
As we live in Gujarat, which harvest festival do we celebrate?
Makar Sankranti. Likewise, people from Punjab celebrate Lohri. People of Assam celebrate Bihu, etc.
Children, can you list the harvest festivals of other states of India? At the time of harvest, people sing, dance and celebrate.
Great!
When the crops are harvested, grains have to be separated from husk. This process is called threshing, which is followed by winnowing, which separates the grain from the chaff.
It is a very long process.
When and how do they reach our kitchen?
Now the grains have to be stored, otherwise pests can spoil them.
How are food grains stored?
After separating the grain from chaff, they are dried completely and stored in big earthen pots, metal pots and jute sacks. Then these are kept in a godown.
The merchants purchase the grains from the godown and take them to their shop, from where people purchase them and bring them to their house.
Finally, it reached our house.
In olden days, how our grandfather used to store these seeds?
Children, you also think how people in the past used to store these seeds.
He used to store the seed in big, cool, dark rooms in big utensils. They even used to keep few good quality seeds in dry gourd and then cover it with mud. These seeds were used to grow crops of next generation.
Once, I with your maternal grandfather prepared a wooden box in which there were 3 to 4 compartments. We filled each compartment with different variety of seeds and covered them with dry neem leaves to protect them from pests and harmful insects.
These days, farmers use chemical fertilizers and pesticides which are not good for crops and seeds. Nowadays, nobody uses indigenous ways.
Are chemical fertilizers and pesticides harmful for crops?
Yes, they make the soil acidic, which has led to the decrease in agriculture production.
It's a matter of concern.
We can save the soil if we use manure, compost, etc.
Mother, today we will also dig a hole in our yard and collect fruits and vegetable peels, dry leaves, etc. to make compost. We will also inform other farmers to follow the same.
Yes, sure. We will do this.
Father, our teacher told us that our country, India, is the agriculture-based nation.
Yes, children. India is a country where more than 50% of the population is involved in agriculture. We are the second largest producer of fruits in the world.
Really, Father?
Yes, children.
Father, when we will grow up, we want to educate our farmer friends about the latest modern techniques of farming so that they can improve agriculture production and bring our nation on the first position in the world. This will also help in eradicating poverty from our country.
Wow, children, it's a great thought.
Children, today you have gathered information about the journey of seed from your father. Let us go home now.
We hope you would have liked the video. We hope that the given information would be beneficial for you. Thank you.